the Pallister government is in a battle with the King's Head pub, and that's not fair. I'm fighting for the safety of all individuals in Manitoba.
The owner of the King's Head pub says a select few small businesses in the province are being targeted for speaking out against what they call a massive failure by the provincial government.
They were the ones telling us, hey, a second wave is going to happen months and months ago, and they just were not prepared.
Christopher Graves says only the restaurants that were speaking out were initially getting shut down. He says as cases rose, the government avoided a full shutdown and picked specific businesses they classified as bars to close. He says they were operating as a restaurant but were closed anyways. He says he was one of only 9 businesses in all of Manitoba that initially faced closure.
It's so minimalistic. There's like a little bit of a shutdown for the restaurant industry, and then there's another shutdown for the majority of the restaurant industry. And then, you know, churches are still allowed to stay open, in gyms. And now here we are, cases still rising, and yet schools are still open. It just doesn't make any sense.
He accuses the Pallister government of being reactive, not proactive, and he doesn't have high hopes for the province-wide lockdown that starts tomorrow.
We're going to be right back here again in 2 weeks, and then we're going to shut schools down, and businesses are then going to have to suffer that again and stay closed even longer.
He says the hospitality industry has been the scapegoat for this government, but when this pandemic is over, they'll be called upon to get the economy up and running again. In the meantime, the province has pledged $5,000 to small businesses forced to close Thursday.
And the premier sits there with his crocodile tears, talking about how important small business is to him, and then in the same breath says he knows it's not enough money. And there is money there in the rainy day fund for them to be able to provide us more.
A spokesperson for the premier says, we will continue to act on the advice of Dr. Rusin and our healthcare experts and implement the measures necessary to help limit the spread of COVID-19 and protect all Manitobans, especially our most vulnerable. Graves hopes the government closes schools immediately along with everything else for the duration of this shutdown. In Winnipeg, Mike Albanese, City News.